We're here at Idlewild Airport talking to the world's preeminent doctor, the most respected physician in modern medicine today, Dr. Helmut Guttenspiel. Doctor? Doctor?
Vat.
Just a few questions,
Vat.
If I may.
Can't hear a word you're saying. What, you got something in your throat there?
Well, actually...
Vat!
Doctor...
Ah! Oh! Oh, that was a shock. Oh, thank you. Hello.
Hello.
Wait a second. Hold it. You got something in your eye there. I don't like the look of it. Wait. Hold still. Hold still. It's me. I'm seeing myself. I got a star in my eye. Oh, I better see a doctor. That's $20. You can pay me later.
Now, doctor, I understand you're here in America to announce an astounding new breakthrough in modern medicine. The cure of the ordinary common cold.
That's right. That's right. I have removed the common cold from the face of the world. Mostly the nose. That all starts.
Well, that's amazing.
Right up there.
And could you tell us, doctor, what that cure consists of?
The cure for the common cold is a cup of hot tea. Hot tea. Very hot. Honey and brandy.
Well, my mother's been using that for years.
Your mother?
That's right.
A cup of hot tea, hot tea, honey and brandy?
That's right.
Then my lawyers will be calling her in the morning. She may be your mama, but the woman's a crook.
I respect your work, sir, but this is common knowledge. People have been using hot tea, honey, and brandy for centuries.
Well, Mr. Smarty Pants, mine cures baldness.
I don't think so.
I don't like it here. I'm going back to Dusseldorf. You can all sneeze your heads off.
Next, the caveman?
Didn't they change that today?
No, it's the caveman. Harry, how did it go?
They loved it.
I know they loved it. What do you think matters to me?
It was terrific.
Terrific, but you didn't say you loved it.
I loved it.
Say it again.
Max, I loved it.
I almost believe you. Hello, girls. Have a great show.
Thanks, Mr. Prince.
A grown man with two children. Look what he does for a living. If Pop was alive, what would he say, Harry?
He'd laugh.
Yeah? You think so?
Yeah.
20 seconds, Max.
Ready.
What are you doing, Max? We changed the running order this afternoon. Next, it's the party at Buckingham Palace with the Queen.
Holy shit.
What do we do?
She invited a caveman. Okay?
In 1954, in New York City, I became the newest and youngest writer on the staff of the Max Prince Show. It was the number one comedy show of its time, but times change quickly in television. My name is Lucas Nader. Please remember it, because Max Prince rarely does.
Looking at the screen, there's the Queen of England having dinner with a caveman.
What are you thinking, Max? You don't have lines for that.
Neither did the Queen. So I let her talk and I ate all the chicken.
Bones and all.
But I didn't crack once. Inside, I was hemorrhaging. But I didn't crack.
See you, Max.
Pure genius, Max. Inspirational. My head is off to you.
You don't have a head.
Take off your hair.
Max had a great show tonight. How do you boys think of all that stuff?
Well, I had this idea about the Queen and a caveman.
All right. I got someone who's dying to meet you. My niece from the South.
And the North ain't so bad either.
Darlene Drew, very talented young actress. Darlene, this is the great Max Prince.
Hello, how do you do?
This is such an honor, Mr. Prince.
We just started getting a program down in Nashville. It doesn't come in too clear, and I don't quite always understand it, but oh, I laugh myself sick anyway.
Thank you very much. Very kind of you. Come on, Dennis, I'm married. No, I don't do that. A pleasure to meet you. Enjoy your stay in New York.
Thank you.
Max, you don't turn that down. You give it to your writers. One gets a leg, one gets an arm, I'll take a win.
As far as the show's concerned, it's so big, even like...
Hey, Jack! Max. Max, look. Walter Winchell.
Good luck, fella.
Hey, Walter!
Screw him.
I would if he'd say something nice about me in his column.
Best not to get him angry, Max. He is dangerous.
Not to a caveman.
How you doing, Max?
Good, Walter. Nice. Okay.
As articulate as ever, huh? What's this I hear about NBC not being happy with your ratings? True?
I don't know, Walter. I don't read my ratings.
And I don't read my fan mail. Nice seeing you, Max.
It's getting late. Max, let's call it a night, yes?
Come on, come on. Where you guys going? We're having laps here. Waiter, where's my steak sandwich?
You already ate it, Max.
Yeah? Was it good?
Another round.
Hey, where's my eyebrow?
I wasn't scared, Harry. I walk out of the... Sad they're doing the sketch. I'm in the wrong costume. And I wasn't scared. I loved it. What? Oh, these aren't drugs. The doctor gave them to me. The subscription pills. Never scared on camera. Only before and after.
The kids, they leave for school already?
There's no school today, Max.
No school? Why not?
Sunday.
Yeah?
Did you watch the show, Faye?
Yes.
Was it good?
It's always good, Max.
Did you like Errol Flynn? He was funny, wasn't he?
Errol Flynn?
He was the guest star. You missed that part?
He was the guest 2 weeks ago, Max, not last night. We have to talk.
Don't say it, Faye. I'm warning you nice. I'm under a lot of pressure. I get one day off a week, and I don't know what day that week is.
Please, don't answer that, Max. The kids are waiting for us to take them to the movies. I said you'd go.
I'm not answering. I'm going to the movies. Harry, you answer it.
Hello. Yeah?
It's him, isn't it?
Yeah, he's here.
The bastard calls me at home on a Sunday.
I'll ask him.
Oh, it's Mr. Network, right? Mr. just got back from church playing croquette balls with his blonde wife and blonde kids. Calls to tell me the ratings dipped a half a hundredth of a point, right?
Hold on. He wants to say hello.
Tell him I died. I mean it. Tell him I'm dead. Tell him to get a living person to replace me next week. Tell him, Harry.
Hello? He died. In the kitchen. A few minutes ago.
I choked on French toast. The funeral is Tuesday.
Okay. He'll call you at your office tomorrow.
Get the guns, Harry. We're going outside.
Daddy!
Dad! Are you coming?
Supposed to be really great. Mom's waiting in the car.
Write down a name in a movie. I promise I'll be there, sweetheart. Tell Mom I just have some very important exploding to do. Let's go, Harry!
Tell me who's sitting on the table, Harry.
The network.
Which ones?
The president and all the vice presidents.
Who else?
Their wives, their maids, their dogs, and their horses.
Right. Okay. Now they gotta get a whole new network.
Okay. It's settled. At exactly 9 o'clock tomorrow morning, a state of war exists between Max Prince and the NBC network. November 3rd, 1954. A date that will live in ignominy.
You can't go on like this without sleep.
Oh, I was just sleeping. I got up for a 2-minute timeout.
You've already had 2 pills, Max.
I'm not getting any pills. I have to pee. Wake you?
It's okay.
It's not okay. It's 2:45. Never say okay to me when it's not okay.
Okay.
I want to go into work early tomorrow. Can you be here at 9:15?
Sure.
Don't say sure unless you know you can do it. Can you do it?
I live in your guest house, Max. How long could it take?
We're declaring war on the network. I'm making you my general, Harry. My adjutant general. You like that?
It's too much.
Too much? Why? What do you want to be?
A corporal. A corporal's fine, Max.
My brother can't be a corporal. It doesn't look good. Okay, you're a captain.
Okay.
This is classified information, Harry. Tell no one. You hear? Not even Mom.
Mom is dead.
I know. That's how quiet I want it. This conversation is now over. All right, pay attention. This is your post. You stand here if it takes all night. Pay attention! I have enemies. You see anything? Hear anything? You bark. You understand? As if your lives depended on it. Any questions? Good doggies.
It is necessary to investigate before legislating. But the line between investigating and persecuting is a very fine one, and the junior senator from Wisconsin has stepped over it repeatedly.
Bastard.
His primary achievement has been in confusing the public mind as between the internal and the external threats of communism. But we cannot defend freedom abroad by deserting it at home. The actions of Senator McCarthy caused alarm and dismay amongst our allies abroad.
Looks foggy today. Alfred, is it foggy out there?
No, Mr. Prince. Just in here.
There. Now Long Island is foggy. Did I call you last night?
No.
Oh, maybe I dreamt I called you.
Could be.
You should have dreamt you answered.
I was usually the first rider to arrive at work, but I was always afraid I'd meet Max alone. The one time I did talk to him alone, he never answered me until I realized he was sleeping. And what amazed me is that even when sleeping, Max was funny.
Morning, Cecil.
Floor, please.
23. It's Lucas. Remember, I'm the new writer on the show.
Ain't they got enough writers up there?
Hope not.
Hold it! Hold it!
I parked on the Triborough Bridge. Didn't you hear me?
Got another new coat you're wearing?
It's a cape, an antique. I took it off a dead bullfighter in Spain. That's a joke, Cecil. Laugh. Christmas is coming soon.
Hi, Milt.
Hey, Ernie. I didn't notice you. Get a personality. I just broke every record on the Henry Hudson Parkway, door-to-door, Scarsdale to 54th Street, 28 minutes and 12 seconds. Made every light. Can you imagine if I had a car? Ba-dum-bum!
I consider that a proposal of marriage. My wife won't take it lightly.
By the way, my name is Lucas.
Not Ernie?
No.
Too late, I already learned Ernie.
Max hasn't even said hello to me yet, and I've been here 2 months.
Don't worry, it usually takes Max 6 months to recognize somebody.
Good morning, Gail. I see you still insist on being gorgeous every day.
Your wife called, wants to know where you are.
Oy, she thinks I cheat in the morning. Is Max in yet?
Does it sound like it?
No, nothing's breaking.
The Max Prince Show.
So where'd you get the beret?
I got it in Paris. Last one sold.
The last beret in Paris?
MGM bought them all up for Gene Kelly movies.
Look, he believes me.
Max is here.
Good morning, Mr. Prince.
We'll see. It's early yet.
Oh, good morning, Max. Hello, Harry.
What did they send this morning?
The network? Nothing.
No memos? They missed the day without memos?
I didn't see any.
No memos, huh? You know why, Harry? They're saving them so they can memo me to death. And they'll bury me in a folded memo in the Mount Memo Cemetery in Memo Park, New Jersey.
You want your coffee, Max?
When I'm through. Dry cleaned and pressed.
Like always, Max.
Check my pockets. I don't want my keys and my comb pressed.
Yes, Max.
Now, my coffee?
Oh, right. Oh, you got one call. Mr. Weebs from the network asks if you can meet with him in his office sometime today. I'll get your coffee.
It starts, Harry. We meet on the field of battle. You notice how they all have names? Like Cal Weebs from Princeton. Bob Blue went to Yale. Bula Bula Bob Blue, and his two sons, too, Bill Blue and Boo Blue. You know who built Harvard, Harry? Chip Chap. Chip Chap built Harvard and Boston, am I right?
Right.
And that's who runs the network. Cal Weebs, Bob Blue, Bill Blue, Boo Blue, and Chip Chap. And because the ratings of my show went down a slice last week, Cal Weebs, Bill Blue, Bob Blue, Boo Blue, and Chip Chap are only worth $2 quillion today. Am I right?
Be careful, Max. It's hot.
To Chip Chap and his two sons, Chip Chap Chappy and Chip Chap Choppy.
Me when I dress like this, especially Max.
Why? You're a funny guy.
True. But compared to the comic minds in this room, I'm Herbert Hoover's kitchen help. So, I wear yellow suede shoes on Columbus Day, a ratty beaver coat on Yom Kippur, and Max laughs. And when Max Prince laughs, my kids eat this week.
Well, you make me laugh.
Because you have taste. Here, it's a gift. I'm up to my ass in berets.
And you don't think you're funny?
Cheap laughs. These guys are Tiffany's. What they have in quality, I make up for in quantity. Bulk, volume, that's my humor. Did Max get in yet? Something's up. He called me last night, drunk as hell. 12 a.m. midnight. 12 a.m. is midnight, Putz. That's right. Be funny before work starts. Hey, Ernie, look for a pumpernickel bagel for me, will you? His name is Arnie.
It's Lucas.
It's not Ernie?
It's not even Arnie. It's not even pumpernickel.
Milt, don't bother me. It's too early in the day to say go fuck yourself.
There's no such word as fuck. A person cannot fuck themselves. You cannot be a U.S. citizen until you say go fuck yourself.
Kiss my naturalization papers, okay?
Do you like the way Val dresses, Arnie? He buys all his clothes at Ellis Island.
You think it's funny that Max called me at 12 a.m. midnight?
Only when you say it.
He was drunk, and it sounded like he was taking pills.
Really? What does taking pills sound like?
I don't know, Milt. What does getting fired sound like? I wonder if he called anybody else. Did he call you, Louis?
Lucas. No. Why would he call me? Is anything wrong?
I don't know. I was out last night. I went to see a play.
What was it?
What the hell was it? It was downtown. Somewhere in the village.
This is our head writer, Arnie. A man who learned to talk English from a dog who barks at night.
Is that right? I got news for you. My dog dreams funnier than you.
My dog can say fucking pumpernickel.
Oh, wait. I remember the play. Hedda Gabler.
Hedda Gabler? Is this about a turkey?
You fucking illiterate. I'll bet you $500 right now you don't know Henrik Ibsen's first name.
You just said Henrik.
I did? All right, I'll bet you $250. Ha! That's funny. And it's even funnier with my accent.
Brad, Harley.
Morning, Cal.
Have a nice weekend.
Fine, thanks. How's Pippa? She mentioned to Atlanta something about dinner this week?
Yes, might have to push that back a bit. Corky and Jigger coming down from school tonight. Sit down, boys. I suppose you've had a gander at the Max Prince ratings? We're still very big in New York, holding our own in Boston and Chicago. Slight dip in L.A. So-so in Washington, not so-so in Detroit.
That trend started late last season. He insists on doing those Italian or Japanese movie takeoffs in double talk. Outside of New York, whoever saw a Japanese movie?
I'm setting up a meeting with him today. He's a goddamn comic genius, but he's a stupid son of a bitch. I don't want to lose him yet, but I got sponsor trouble. Comic geniuses don't sell Buicks or washing machines.
You know what Max is like. He's not going to be easy to talk to.
Well, we can always put a slab of raw meat in front of him.
How you doing, Cecil?
Same thing. Just waiting to retire.
Well, I may be leaving here soon myself. Hollywood is... they want me to...
You don't have any idea why Max called?
None. He spoke to my maid in Swedish. Double talk Swedish. To a woman who is here 3 weeks from Peru. She was still crying when we came home. Honey, would you try that number again, please? Hey, Milt, you know the rules. God damn it, is this a business call or a personal call? I don't know. Let's see who answers.
Seems incredible, coming from Russia, that you become a comedy writer. I mean, do they have television there?
Television? They don't have doorbells yet.
Hello, who's this? No, I'm calling Colette.
Colette? We have a show tonight. You are calling some girl Colette?
Colette. Her name is Colette. I think he even listened with an accent.
Hey, this is not a day to get me angry, Milt. I swear to God.
Oh.
Brian O'Malley is smiling. Something happened. He met someone cute at the convent.
You got me for 5 more days, guys. I fly out to Hollywood on Monday. The Gentile makes good.
Hollywood?
Sold my screenplay to MGM.
You're serious?
Every week he is flying to Hollywood. Every week he sold a screenplay to MGM or 20th Century Fox.
Not Fox, Fox, I keep telling you.
You really have a deal?
As soon as they okay the script.
They didn't okay it yet?
They'll okay it as soon as they read it.
They didn't read it yet?
They'll read it as soon as I write it.
You didn't write it yet?
Here, it's all up here. Every page, every word, every comma.
They made a deal for your finger pointing to your head?
You jealous bastards. I told the idea to my agent. He told it to MGM. See these guys, Lucas? 30 years from now, they'll be writing game shows, and I'll be the VP of MGM screwing Lana Turner.
When she's 62? Why?
Ow!
Where does it hurt, Max?
Oh, here in my chest.
That's your stomach.
It depends on what I eat.
Do you have any pain in the arm?
I used to get it when I was in the Navy. A heart attack doesn't take that long, does it? Oh, Jesus.
Dr. Snyder can't come, Max, but he'll take you in his office now. Alfred has a car downstairs. Should I get your suit back from the cleaner?
Why, I had to look good for a heart attack.
You're not having a heart attack.
Yeah, show me your diploma, Harry. Oh, Jesus, I feel like I ate a steak knife.
What should I tell Mr. Weeks about the meeting?
2:00. I'll be there dead or alive. If I'm dead, let Chip Chap Chappy do the show.
Max, I was just on my way to see you. I think you should take a look at these figures. The budget is getting way out of control.
What about the budget? Are we going over budget?
No, no, we're right on budget. No problem. Are you all right, Max?
I'm perfect. Never better. No! Helen, call my lawyer. I better go over my will again. If anything happens to me, charge the funeral to NBC. Fuck them.
Shouldn't he wear his pants? Just now? Well, is it serious? How'd he look? All right. All right, I'll tell them. I got bad news.
We have to pay for our own bagels?
Harry is rushing Max to the doctor, holding his chest.
Why is Harry holding Max's chest?
Max is holding his chest.
Is it his heart?
Who knows?
I've seen it coming. You can't eat an entire herd of cattle each year and stay healthy.
That is not funny. I absolutely forbid any jokes.
That wasn't a joke. It was a dietary observation.
I just saw Max get in his limo. Anything wrong?
Carrie is rushing him to his doctor.
I figured he was half undressed already.
Did he say anything to you?
Well, I could only see his ass, and I didn't care to hear what it had to say.
Maybe he saw it coming. He called me at midnight last night, mumbled something about NBC.
He called me at 2 a.m.
What'd he say?
Something like, we're going to war again.
With the Japanese?
I don't know. It depends on how Japanese NBC is.
It's all those pills he takes, and the scotch.
That explains it. We're going to war with the scotch, the Japanese, and NBC.
With all that stuff, how does he get out of bed in the morning?
His wife has a giant spatula.
He never makes it to bed. Goes to sleep on the floor with his dogs.
That's why he's holding his chest. He's trying to get rid of the ticks.
Max has been very paranoid lately. Has anyone noticed?
Isn't it impolite to watch someone being paranoid?
Who would be threatening him?
Obviously, it would be the Scotch, the Japanese, and the paranoians.
No, Max is worried. That's why he bought those hunting dogs.
They're not hunting dogs. They point to food in supermarkets.
Ugh. Not a word about this to Faye.
No.
Or my kids.
No.
Or to the network.
No.
No, maybe the network should know. If I die, we got some big lawsuit.
You're not gonna die, Max.
If they hear I'm sick, they'll try to squeeze out of my contract. Don't tell the network.
I won't.
Oh! Faye's put up with a lot for me, Harry. All these years. She deserves better. She's the only woman I loved in my whole life.
Jesus, look at the body on that girl.
You don't really want a baby, do you?
I never said that.
You don't try enough, that's the problem.
But when do we get the chance? You're always up there in the writer's room every night till 8, 9 o'clock. You don't get home till 10.
Well, we'll start at 10, right in the doorway. Have a glass of wine ready.
And you come home smelling from cigars. Then you're in the tub scrubbing it off till 12. My sperm are asleep by 12.
We can meet in a hotel at lunchtime. It'll take 10 minutes. Bing, bang, and we're out.
We even talk like those guys. And when do you ever go for lunch? There's always a crisis on that show. I'm late for work.
Tonight, get yourself excited. I'll rush right home. I won't even take a bath.
Well, then we have to deal with the cigar smoke.
We'll use it. Pretend it's an orgy. Warren, think positive.
I don't see a thing. Your heart is fine, Max.
So why do I have a flaming coconut in my chest?
Tension, pressure. You got problems, Max?
Doc, do you know what TV ratings are? They're like an EKG of your television set. And I'm losing points, you hear? If it was to another comic, I wouldn't mind. If it was to a big star, Judy Garland, Fred Astaire, I'd understand. But I'm losing to an accordion player in Wisconsin, Lawrence Welk. Every time he squeezes the accordion, he makes cheese.
Max, calm yourself.
He plays polkas, and the band blows bubbles. And he's got three girls milking a cow and singing songs that were old in 1912. But I can't beat the bastard. Why?
Calm down, Max. This Lawrence Welk thing will pass. Who even puts a show like that on the air?
People who make toilet paper and dog chow. Millions of farmers watch the bubbling poker cow milkers sing a song from the Ziegfeld Follies of Yugoslavia, then run out and fill up their garages with toilet paper and dog chow. And I can't beat them! I can't beat them! Put the wires back on, Doc! I'm gonna blow out your Frankenstein machine.
Champagne Tuesday, baby. There's Let's Dance. And here is your host, Lawrence Welk.
Thank you, Meyer. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
That's great news, Max. I knew you'd be all right. Of course we're working. We got 5, 6 wonderful ideas. Don't worry. Take your time. Max is okay. He's on his way back. Let's get something down on paper quick. We pissed away half the morning here.
I know. It's ruining my shoes.
Hey, listen to this. Pope Paul approves of analysis. That means from now on, confession is $80 an hour.
Okay. Maybe there's a sketch in it.
Well, I think we'd all have to take communion first.
Take it. It beats circumcision.
What the hell would a Gentile like you know about circumcision?
Did you ever see him in the men's room? He'd pee straight up the wall.
I took English and biology in college, and now I have no use for them.
Pardon me. But does anyone here notice that Ira is late again? Does it offend anyone that we do all the work and he comes in and takes all the credit? Why do we let this little shithead get away with it?
Because he's funny.
Funny, my ass. He's a hypochondriac. He takes his wife and kids on vacation. He goes to a drugstore.
I had lunch with him once. He fainted 3 times.
Well, he has good days like that now and then.
He's going to walk in here and tell us he got malaria in the Bronx Zoo.
Oh, come on. He's not always like that.
I don't want anyone to worry, but they think I have a brain tumor.
My mistake, guys. Let's kill the fucker.
It's a brain tumor. I'm telling you, I couldn't tie my shoelaces this morning. My 3-year-old son had to tie them for me. I poured tomato juice in my coffee this morning. Tomato juice!
Well, it isn't necessarily a brain tumor. Have you ruled out stupidity?
Remember to say that at my funeral. That's right after you do your little Irish jig right on my coffee.
Ira, there could be lots of reasons for this. Maybe you're just underworked.
Leave him alone. If he wants to have a brain tumor, let him have a brain tumor.
I'm having double vision. I'm seeing everything double. 2 cabs pulled up in front of my house this morning. I took both of them.
Maybe you're just fainting too much.
Oh, I see. You guys all think I'm crazy, right? Like Tolstoy was crazy. Like Dostoevsky was crazy.
No, they were crazy in a talented way. You're just a fucking waste of time crazy.
Okay, you want proof? I'll give you proof. Undeniable, absolute, incontrovertible proof. There it is, in black and white, okay?
You actually wrote on a wall with an indelible marker? A mother would drown her own child for doing that.
They rushed the Sufi special, Max, no extra charge.
Thank you.
Oh, and Mr. Weebs of NBC called, asked if you could push the meeting back to 3.
Yeah, they're starting. No, tell him I'll be there at 2, and if he's not there, Harry and I will meet by ourselves.
Yes, Max.
Back to the office, Mr. Prince.
Yeah. Now, wait. Harry, you want to go out to the cemetery?
Now?
I got the urge. I want to talk to Mom and Pop, see how they're doing.
How could they be doing?
They're not even buried together.
Maybe I can talk him into it. Harry, how old were you the first time you took this ferry?
I was 8.
How old was I?
Nothing. You weren't born yet.
That's right. That's right. I can't remember anything anymore, Harry. I'm scared. What's happening to me?
Too much everything, Max.
Work.
Work.
Scotch.
Scotch.
Pills.
Everything.
It's hard to stop, Harry. It drowns out the anger. Anger can't swim around in scotch. You'd love it if I threw this away, wouldn't you?
What am I gonna tell you, Max?
Fuck it. I don't need it. You knew I had another one, didn't you bastard?
I know my brother.
That's why I need you, Harry. Because you're the only one who doesn't disapprove of me.
People thought Harry was kind of weak, but the truth was that it was Harry's strength that Max depended on. We still hadn't come up with an idea, so we all took a 20-minute break. Carol went across the street to a hotel, but didn't say why. And then she came back.
Have you guys heard the news?
Don't ever burst into this room like that. We all could have been naked.
I just heard it inside on the radio. Joseph McCarthy called General George Marshall a communist.
Unfucking believable.
Calls a 5-star general of the army a card-carrying communist.
Even if he was a communist, why would he have cards printed up?
Do you think this is a joke? America is on the brink of becoming a fascist state. Doesn't that worry you?
McCarthy's a nutcase, a drunken fanatic. How long do you think he's gonna last?
Some of them lasted long enough to kill 6 million Jews.
Ira, either you pay attention to this or go home and have your kid take out your brain tumor.
I'm here, I'm listening, I just have to see how my stocks are doing.
Has it ever occurred to you that you monopolize every minute of this room?
Well, who better than me? What am I, uninteresting?
Listen, I think I have a good idea.
This better be good.
Never mind, there's too much pressure.
Pressure on everybody. This is a terrible time for all of us.
20 to 12, he's right. What?
That was a joke. Not bad. You're in the club, kid. Let's go.
Where are we going?
First time you get a laugh in here, you buy everyone lunch.
Nobody laughed.
So we'll have a small salad.
What is this? What is this? Leaves? Dead birds? I paid you extra to keep this nice.
I do. I brush the leaves every morning, but they blow back.
It's my mother's grave. I want it spotless. You hear?
Yes, Mr. Prince.
And my father's grave, too. Here. Just take away the leaves. He liked birds.
Yes, sir.
Ma, it's Max and Harry. Everything's good. Faye's good. The kids are good. School's good. Harry's not married yet, but he's good.
can't hear you nod your head. Speak up.
I'm good, too.
And the show's good. I'm having a little network problem, but don't get yourself sick over it. Listen, Mom. Have you changed your mind about being next to Pop? Because I think he really misses you. You don't have to talk to him. I think he'd just like to lie next to you. It's cold over there. He doesn't have the sun like you. Okay. I miss you, Ma. A whole lot. Harry misses you, too.
What did she think about moving the grave?
She wants to sleep on it.
I feel so badly for General Marshall. Such a great American. Of all people to call a communist, why him?
I don't know. Val, did you ever see Marshall at one of the meetings?
Are you out of your fucking mind? You don't make jokes like that. Some secretary in here hears that I am subpoenaed in Washington.
Val's right. No communist jokes. None of us are safe today. I've got that blacklist thing, you know?
They have what?
Blacklist. Do you guys realize they can put anyone they want on that list?
Without proof?
In a second, they got a wait list to get on the blacklist.
Not if you tip the maitre d'.
I can't believe they think this is funny. Did any of you see Edward R. Murrow last night?
I don't live in this neighborhood.
What do I have to do to impress you? This is serious.
Well, the whispering was good.
What?
You got pills in your mouth, Max.
Pills? I got no pills. Give me the soda. I got a meeting coming up. I don't want to lose my temper.
This thing with Max is much more serious than we think. God forgive me for mentioning this word, nervous breakdown.
That's two words. God will never forgive you.
Can we stop rushing Max into Bellevue Hospital? Let's not go off half-cocked. That doesn't apply to you, Carol.
I'm trying to get pregnant. I have enough to worry about.
Ask your husband. Why should we do everything?
I'm so sorry, Mr. Prince. Now, Mr. Weebs knows you're here. He's almost through with his call.
Perfectly all right.
You okay?
I'm fine. Don't ask me again.
Ah, he's off. You may go in now, Mr. Prince.
You sure he's ready to see me?
Oh, yes. He just buzzed.
Oh? Well, if he buzzed, he must be ready to see me. Right, Harry?
Is everything all right?
Yes, fine. I just want to finish this article. About these ex-Nazis who formed a polo club in Argentina.
Max will kill Ira when he sees this. Maybe we shouldn't tell him who did it.
I have a brain tumor. Ira has shirts like that. Who else would it be?
Where the hell is he anyway? Where'd he go?
He went to the John. He was feeling faint.
Quick, let someone flush him down the toilet.
Okay, I'm here. Read back what you got.
Besides, I have a brain tumor. That's it.
I don't believe it. Why is it always up to me to get this show started?
You lazy, pointless, little, egocentric turd. When are you ever in the room when we're writing?
Hey, Father Flanagan, nothing happens in this room till I get here, you goddamn leprechaun.
Why are men so vulgar and ugly and disgusting?
Because they don't have time to put on makeup.
Hey, Brian, did anyone ever explain the potato famine to you? You know why it happened? This guy in County Cork got the idea of trying to grow French fries.
Look out!
Why do we have to keep making racial jokes, Irish jokes, Jewish jokes, Italian jokes? Hasn't America progressed beyond that yet?
No, I don't think it has. Not at all.
Go for a while.
No, I wouldn't say so, no.
Max.
Cal, how are you?
Of course you know Brad and Harley.
Good to see you, Max. Hello, Larry.
Harry, his name is Harry.
Of course. Hello, Harry.
Hello. Well, boys, come on, have a seat.
All right. Oh, thank you.
Cigar, Max?
Only when I work.
Harry, I called on Sunday just to tell you Saturday's show was incredible.
Maybe the best of the season.
Thank you.
I appreciate your coming down, Max. I know Monday's a big writing day for you.
All the writing days are big.
Needless to say, the network is very happy with the show here. We look forward not only to another wonderful season this year, but for many years to come. You play a major role in the NBC family, Max.
It's always nice to have an extra family.
And except for some small, minor adjustments here and there, we don't want to change a thing on the show, Max. We'd be fools to.
Nothing comes close to it in television.
It's classic comedy, Max. Critics will talk about it 50 years from now.
Mm-hmm. So what's the small minor adjustments?
Well, they're not really changes, Max. Just tightening some screws and bolts here and there, that's all.
I understand.
I knew you would.
You can't go on doing the same wonderful things year after year. Wonderful gets boring.
We love the family sketches, Max. The Benson Cooper couple. He comes home, finds out his wife's crashed the new car into the liquor store. That's hilarious stuff.
So that screw will leave alone.
Right. People across the country can identify with that. That's what we're looking for. Comedy about people. You know what I mean, Max.
Sure, sure. People comedy about people. We don't want cat comedy or dog comedy. We sure as hell don't want squirrel comedy. We should shoot for the people comedy. Because buffaloes don't buy TV sets, right? Right, Harry?
We also love the rock and roll sketches. The Dizzy Dazzy Brothers with the thick glasses. It's not above their heads.
I'll keep it just under the brow, no higher.
What the boys are trying to say, Max, is, if I may...
Please, it's your network.
Things like the foreign movie takeoffs... Personally, I love them. We all do.
But we have to go after our audience. Our people.
Got it. Our people don't like to watch their people.
It's too urbane for them.
I get it. Yeah, we don't want to urbane them too much. They don't like it when they get too urbanated.
Max, you're the creative one. We're just the corporate guys. But I think we need to open the lines of communication between us.
I got you, Cal. The lines are too clogged with urbanement, right?
In a way. See, we want to put a liaison on the show. A man who understands the creative process. Not to write, not to interfere, merely to observe. This way, if you have a problem, you go through him, he gets in touch with us. If we have a problem, we'll go through the liaison man. He'll be sort of a buffer.
An urbane observer buffer man. Gotcha. Is that it?
That's it.
Good. I'm glad we had this talk. Good meeting, Cal.
Oh, there was one last item.
Oh? Is this a screw or a bolt?
It's a programming thing. Airtime is getting tight, Max. We have sponsors waiting online to get on the air. We'll have to cut back somewhere. The hour and a half show worked before, Max, but we have to streamline. I think 1 hour would be a tighter show.
It would be sleeker, faster paced, more dynamic in a 1 hour slot.
Hit him hard, hit him fast. Less is more, Max.
I'm sure you agree, don't you?
And if I don't?
It would be better if you did.
Sure, Cal. Sure. It's nice when you own a network, isn't it? Let's go, Harry.
That's right, Big Mouth. A funny contest.
Oh, me against you? Where's the challenge? You can have all the other writers.
The game is funny names for as much as you want, asshole.
Oh, is asshole your best name? I already win.
Why do I want children? Look what they grow up to be.
All right, let's get this over with. What's the bet?
Shoes. We're betting shoes. My $60 alligators against his worn-out Irish cop shoes after 5 St. Patrick's Day parades.
Anybody want in on this? Small bet on the side?
I'm in for a pair of shoelaces.
I'll take a tongue.
All right, let's go. Up the Irish.
Screw the Pharaoh.
And we begin.
Rabbi John Wayne.
Beer on a sandwich, hold the mayo.
Mr. and Mrs. Pope John. Ooh.
The Count of Monte through Friday.
Ira Chubnik.
Ira Chubnik. That's me. What's funny about that?
Nothing. Nothing's funny about Ira Chubnik.
You can't use names we already know. Give me those shoes.
The winner!
Oh, holy shit! Oh, God. First McCarthy, now this.
You're looking up here.
Of course, you're waiting for the Sox.
Come on, away from the window. Hurry up.
So we in a break?
There are no breaks. We have had our breaks. We have had a coffee break, a Joe McCarthy break, a possible heart attack break, and a four shoes out the window break. We have used up all our breaks.
Well, then I'll have to ask Carol to turn around, because I'm going to pee in the plant.
Oh, put it away, Milt. The funny contest is over.
Good afternoon, Mr. Prince.
Hello, Max. How are you?
How am I? They just cut the budget by a half hour, Aaron. That's how I am. You happy now?
So, what's up with NBC, Max?
What's up? What's not down is up. What's up could be down, what's down could be up. Unless Cal Weebs wants it shorter. You understand?
Certainly. It's Newton's theory of obscurity, isn't it?
Everything all right?
It's fine.
It all got settled?
It got settled fine.
Was anything decided?
Fine was decided. We decided fine.
No problems?
We had a few problems, but we find them out. I have a brain tumor. I have a brain tumor? Who wrote that?
I did.
Don't lie to me. Who wrote it?
No, I'm telling you, it was me.
Did somebody from NBC do this? Huh? Is that what they're trying to tell me? I have a brain tumor? So they can break the contract?
No, Max, I swear to God, it was me. I wrote it.
Why?
Because I have a brain tumor.
Is that gonna wash off?
You don't care what may happen to me?
First, let's take care of what happened to my wall. Is that gonna wash off?
I don't think so. It's a permanent marker.
If this doesn't wash off, you'll definitely have a brain tumor. All right, we all have to have a talk. Everybody sit. Here's the news from NBC. They're putting a spy on the show.
A spy?
Who are you?
Lucas. Lucas Nader. I've been on the show 3 months now, Max.
Well, sit up straight.
Thank you.
Where was I?
They're putting a spy on the show.
Not a spy. An observer.
An observer?
What, is there an echo in here?
To observe what, Max?
Everything we do. What we eat, what we write, what we think. We're getting an all-out observage.
I knew it. Censorship. It's the beginning of blacklisting. It's Senator McCarthy publicly disgracing a man like General George Marshall.
What? What did he say about Marshall?
It's all over television, Max.
What did he say? Say it slowly. I don't want to miss a word.
Joe McCarthy accused General George Marshall, a 5-star general of the army, of being a communist.
God
We know how you feel, Max.
Not yet. When you ask me, you'll know how I feel. Ask me.
How do you feel, Max?
Thank you.
Oh, my God!
There! That's how I feel!
Somebody get his arm out!
Leave it there! Get a knife! Cut it off! Send it in a box to that no-good bastard! Let him know what I think of him! Helen! Get in here! Call him a communist, huh? I want to hit something else. Something big. Something expensive.
There's a bank across the street, Max.
Yes, Max.
You see this hole? Call Tiffany's. I want this hole framed in their best silver.
Silver.
And underneath, I want a plaque engraved in honor of General George Marshall.
Marshall?
Soldier, statesman, slandered by that son of a bitch!
Son of a bitch.
McCarthy.
McCarthy. Yes, Max.
You really ought to have someone look at that hand, Max.
You're right. Here. You can all look at it. All right.
So, what is this observer going to do, Max?
Do? Do? What'll he do? What'll he do? He'll observe. He'll hang around a show, observing the coffee, the cream cheese, the potato chips. Maybe he'll come up here and observe us working. Observe Ira coming in late. Observe Milt wearing those cockamamie clothes. And then if he's really observant, he'll observe me getting upset. And then he'll observe me taking him aside, very quietly, very politely, putting my fist through his fucking fist!
My God, again.
Jesus. Yeah?
Max, you got a minute? We'd like to talk to you.
Come in. So?
Well, Max, since we three are the original nucleus of the writing staff, except for Kenny, whose idea this was, we just wanted to get something off our chest.
Except for Carol, she wants to keep hers.
Okay, so?
What we wanted to say, Max, is we're worried about you, about your health.
My health? What's wrong with my health? The doctor said I'm fine. Knock wood.
Yeah, we saw you knock wood today, Max. A lumberjack couldn't have punched a hole in the wall like that.
I was a little upset.
Look, Max, I know you the longest, so maybe I can be the most honest with you. Lately, you've been acting like a lunatic. You've been like a 2,000-pound gorilla just had all his wives taken away.
I'm a gorilla, huh?
What we're trying to say, Max, is that we think you've been taking too many pills. And pills and scotch don't mix, Max. Or Max mix, however you want.
What pills? Well, you mean those two little tranquilizers I take once a week?
You take them once a week every night, Max.
They're harmless. Remember the night you weren't feeling well? I gave you half a pill. Did anything happen?
I don't remember. I slept for 9 days.
Have I ever missed a rehearsal? Have I ever missed a writing session? Was I ever drunk or sleepy on the air?
No, never, Max.
That I bet my life on.
Yeah, but who wants to win your life?
There's no problem. I'm telling you.
We hope so, Max. We wanted to make sure you're okay.
Thank you. I appreciate that. There's two things I would never harm in this life. My wife, my kids, and this show.
That's three, Max, but we get the point.
You all mean a lot to me. I want you to know that.
One last thing, Max. We didn't get much written today. We were wondering, maybe we should stay late and work on the show tonight?
Sure. If you want, let's stay.
Listen, I think we should get a good night's sleep and come in earlier tomorrow.
That's good, too. Let's do that one.
All right, let's leave him alone. Good night, Max.
Good night.
No, Max. We're too far behind. I say we stay, we work.
Whatever you want.
Okay, well, let's have something good to eat first. Just pick out any place you don't mind paying.
Salmon looks nice.
How can you tell? It just says poached salmon. You mean you like the way they printed it?
Kenny, what are you going to have?
I think the Caesar salad, not too well done.
I'll have the chicken salad with Russian dressing.
Russian? What, are you crazy in times like this?
That's ridiculous, but make it a Caesar salad.
And give him the Irish stew. Scotch and soda dressing. And serve it in his lap. And no knives and forks. He doesn't use them.
Max, a steak for you? Max?
Oh, God. He took the pills and didn't tell us.
Max, all right?
What?
Just checking.
I heard everything. Iris said let's work, so let's work. Who are all these people?
We're in the restaurant, Max.
Oh. Jeez, we got here fast.
Salmon isn't so good.
Maybe they misspelled it.
All right, I'll pitch first. What about a movie takeoff?
No foreign movies. The network would be on Max's S.
You could always have it lanced.
Do you like being disgusting?
You have salmon bones sticking out of your teeth, and I'm disgusting.
Hey, what about doing Julius Caesar with Max playing Marlon Brando? Just open it.
It's a great idea. Let's do it.
We don't do nothing till I say so, and I don't say so till Max says so. What do you think, Max? Max, you think it's a good idea?
I will take.
Would you like me to cut that out for you, Max?
Not yet. When I'm through eating.
Over here. Over here. What do we do? Let him sleep it off?
I'll sit with him. You guys go on up.
You okay, Harry?
I'm all right.
When you're a big star in television, rich and famous, people think you have everything. But sometimes, everything comes down to just having a large, warm arm to lean on.
You're inviting me for breakfast, Milt.
I wanted to talk to you. My wife's leaving me.
To go shopping or for good? I'm sorry. It's working on this show. Are you serious?
I'm never serious. She always is, which is why I think she's leaving me.
You seem to be taking it well.
I tried to patch it up. I offered to take her on a second honeymoon. She said she didn't like the first one that much.
Sometimes, Milt, I think you sell yourself a little short.
Honey, I'll sell myself in whatever size they'll buy me.
I'll get breakfast.
Are you open for New Year's Eve? Hi, Mr. Prince. Not hungry today?
Not yet.
I heard you fainted last night in Walter Winchell's column.
I fainted in Walter Winchell's column?
No, I read it in his column. It was in some restaurant.
No. I think it was food poisoning.
Oh, because you said you were having trouble with the networks. Why would you have trouble with the networks? Everybody loves you.
Thank you. That's nice of you to say.
So I'm glad it was only food poisoning.
Myron. Any word on MGM? Well, you better look for something. I don't know how long this ship will stay afloat. What? No, I'm not on a boat. Myron, read a book sometime.
Hi, David.
Oh, morning, thank you, Dave.
It's so cold the pigeons are crapping sleep, but I'm pumped.
So cold, I should have worn more lipstick.
I would like a comment on the outfit, please.
2,000 rats on a bus. Thank
you. Well, it's official. I'm pregnant.
Wonderful news.
Was it from the time we were stuck in the elevator?
Mazel tov.
Thank you.
No, I was suggesting a name.
Oh.
What's the due date?
October 5th.
I know a delivery company can get it here by June.
Boy, that's some snow.
How'd you get in, Max?
We walked, the two of us.
From Long Island?
No, from the hotel across the street. We slept there. Dave, we got everybody here?
Ready to go, Max.
Good. Thank you, Harry.
You're welcome, Max.
Good morning.
Morning,
Max. Dave, you got the gotkas?
The gotkas. Togas.
That's it.
Oh, the togas, yes. Wardrobe.
Great. Thank you.
From the top, Max.
Give me a second, Dave.
Here it comes.
So, you got a good seat to observe everything?
Yes, fine, Mr. Prince.
Because we could move closer. We could do it right here in front of you. You wouldn't miss an observation.
I'm really happy here, Mr. Prince.
Did you observe me coming into rehearsal 4 minutes late? Better put that in your observable book.
Mr. Prince, I'm trying to make myself as inconspicuous as possible.
Anything you want. I could put a curtain around you. No one would see you. What's your name?
Lawrence.
From Arabia?
No, from Tarrytown.
Okay, Lawrence. We're gonna rehearse Julius Caesar now. Here. Take my cigar. Now, if we start to do something too urbane for Tarrytown, puff the cigar 3 times, and then I'll come over and we'll chit-chat it out. Okay?
Okay.
I'm ready, Dave.
Okay, Max.
Is the cast ready?
I'd give Lawrence of Arabia 3 minutes. Any bets?
NBC must be giving this guy suicide pay.
Ready on the observation deck?
Yes.
fine here. Thank you.
We're all ready.
The mail plane made it through the snow! We've got the serum! The president's daughter is saved!
Only Ira. Only Ira.
Oh, I'm sorry. Were you rehearsing?
How many times have I told the writers nobody comes late to rehearsals?
I don't know, Max. I'm never here when you tell them.
Did you get that, Larry? Let's start, please.
High-class movies present William Shakespeare's Julius Caesar, starring Marlon Merlin in his first completely memorized part as Julius Caesar. Rome, 44 BC. The time is 10 minutes to XXI. Brutus speaks.
Hail, Cassius.
Hail, Brutus.
What news of Flavius and Lepidus?
Not well. Flavius has mucus and Lepidus is nauseous.
What of the conspiracy?
We must be cautious, Brutus. Linus told Paulus he thinks 'tis much hocus pocus. Yet Flavius said Lepidus swears Marcus thinks justice is with
us. Okay, that's enough for that here. Get me into the goddamn sketch already. Maybe last year, when we had an hour and a half, we could do Linus has mucus and Marcus is nauseous. But this is this year, and NBC is looking to fuck us.
Where were we, Dave?
Lepidus swears Marcus thinks justice is with us.
Okay, go on. I'm begging you.
Caution. Caesar is upon us.
Hail, O Caesar.
Greetings, Caesar.
And happy holidays to you.
What doest thou seekest in the constellation, O Caesar?
Is this looking fancy? A cluster of stars in the heavens.
And what does this cluster be named, O Caesar?
It is called Stella. Stella for starlight. Where are you?
I like that. That's good. Good joke, Kenny.
What do you mean, Kenny? It's my joke.
Who cares?
I care. Don't give him credit.
He's right, Max. It was his.
It makes no difference. I don't want no prima madonnas in
here. It makes a difference to me. Either give me credit or I'm taking my Stella joke back.
No. I paid for Stella. I own Stella. You can have Linus, Paulus, Hocus, Docus. You can have Marcus, Mucus, and Nauseous. You can even have Sookus, Tookus, and Smuckus, but Stella is mine!
Okay.
All right, let's get back to work.
Stella, will soccer balling with me? Is that smoke signal for me, Lawrence?
Well, with all due respect, I'm not sure people in the Midwest want to see Shakespeare's Julius Caesar.
That may be true, Lawrence. That may be too horribly true. But this isn't Shakespeare's Julius Caesar. This is the Sookus Tookus Schmuckus version.
Still, I think it's something we should discuss with Mr. Weebs.
No. We will not discuss this with Mr. Weebs. We will discuss this with we. Your we and my we. Only, I don't think you'll have too much to say, Lawrence, because it's hard to talk without a fucking tongue in your mouth! You'll be or not to be, Larry! That's a question!
Be careful! Get him
on the ground! Hang in!
Max!
We dropped 6 points in Detroit, 8 in Cincinnati. And Milwaukee turned off the lights and went to sleep.
He does a takeoff on Julius Caesar. Maybe in college you do that, not on television.
He just doesn't get it.
So I get this call from Aaron, the bookkeeper. The show's been over budget every week this season, and Max is responsible for the overage. He owes the network about a third of his salary.
And he never told us.
Now, this comes from Aaron, not Max. He's cutting one person from costumes, one from sets, one from the camera crew, one from the secretaries, and the last one is the hardest.
One from the writers?
Yeah.
Well, I personally volunteer that it's Ira.
Max will be down in a few minutes. He really appreciates your all coming up here to work today.
How's he feeling?
It's a bad flu, and he's run down. I think preempting the show last week got him down, too.
Well, he'll feel better now that we're going back to work.
You like working with Max?
It's the greatest thing that ever happened to me, even though I don't think he notices me much.
Me too, sometimes. Can you get that, Lucas? I told Max I'd wake him when the writers were here.
Sure.
I can't believe I got a speeding ticket on the parkway. I was driving so slow, the cop who chased me was walking.
You slept 10 hours, you didn't wake up once.
I didn't take any pills, I swear.
I haven't had you to myself that long in 8 years.
Don't laugh at me. But I had this great sexual dream about us last night. I was hoping tonight...
Max, it wasn't a dream.
It wasn't? Oh, and I missed it? Why didn't you wake me?
You were doing fine the way you were. The writers were here.
Hey. This summer, just you and me, we go to Europe. Yes?
Well, let's see if they can get our bed in the plane first.
I just heard the news in my car. Did you hear it?
No, I wasn't in your car.
Stalin died. Joseph Stalin is dead.
Really? So I guess you'll be going to the funeral.
Milt, I want you to listen to this because I have been practicing with a tutor. Go fuck yourself.
He said it right. You said it right. You actually went to a tutor to learn to say that?
Absolutely. Cost me a fucking fortune.
You mean he only taught you to say it once?
No. He only taught me to say it to you. What a day. How is Max? What is that? Hmm? A white suit?
Oh, my God. What did the cleaners do to my blue serge?
You didn't know Max hates white suits?
Max does?
Since he was a kid, no one told you about Max and white suits?
It's a joke, right? Not necessarily the kind you laugh at.
I swear to God. When Max's father died, they made a mistake and buried him in someone else's white suit. Max had nightmares about it for years. Half his analysis was about white suits.
I think my wife knew. She was laughing when I left the house this morning.
Can I help you?
I was looking for Mrs. Prince.
Oh, she had the parents' meeting at school.
Ah, I see. I wonder if you can do me a favor. We're writing a new sketch inside for the show, and we need a man's suit for a couple of hours. A dark suit with dark shoes. Something in Mr. Prince's closet would be fine.
Oh, you want me to ask him?
No. You see, it's sort of a surprise for Mr. Prince. I want to walk in the living room wearing the suit. You get a kick out of it.
Well, he's taking a shower now.
I understand. But when you see him coming down the stairs, could you just poke your head in the living room and nod to me? Then I'll go up and get the suit.
Hi, Carol. Do you need any help?
No, thanks. I've had enough help from men. Oh, please. No one stand between me and this sofa.
Oh. Hey! That's next week's sketch. Moby Dick.
Your wife's crazy, Milt. You're everything a woman desires. Oh, God. Didn't anyone tell you about Max and white suits?
Where's Max?
He's taking a shower.
Great suit, Milt. You look like the governor of Devil's Island.
Okay, here. And give me a text receipt. I'm a doctor.
I have had, without a doubt, one of the greatest days of my life.
Let me guess. Your spleen broke, your kidney failed, and your prostate fell out.
No, Patty, me love, me health is perfect. I do have a gas blockage that could blow up Pittsburgh, but it'll pass.
Someone change seats with me?
That's right. Save yourself. Forget the pregnant woman.
So, what was so perfect about today?
I realized how happy I am. I love my wife. I love my son. I love my mother. Not every day, but I love her. And most of all, I love this job. I love my work. I get paid a lot of money to make people laugh. Yep. I got it made. I can't believe this. Max is going to cut one of the writers? My God. I mean, one of you guys has got to go? Ugh.
Mr. Freeze is coming down the stairs.
No, I said before he comes down the
stairs. Okay, before we start work, we have to have a meeting. You too, Milt. Everybody sit down. I'm not feeling well, Max. I'll be right back. I have to use the John.
Are you sick? You look white as a ghost.
I got a bladder infection. It makes you look very pale.
So how does this work, Max? Who picks the one who's going?
Harry picks him. All the names are in the hat. Whichever name he picks is gone. I hope it's no one here. Oh, my God. What color suit is that?
It's an off-color cream beige taupe antique eggshell.
Where's my glasses? I left them upstairs. Carol, if you're not busy, would you mind?
I'll get him. No problem. I'll be right back.
Did you see that? I think he's been hanging out with ballet dancers. All right. We're going to pick the name out of the hat. Not Harry's. Harry's not a writer, so he doesn't get fired. Wait a minute. I changed my mind. Carol? You pick the name, because your name isn't in there either.
Why not?
Because you're pregnant. I don't fire pregnant women.
Oh, really? Since when did anyone notice I was a woman?
I noticed when you started work for us. You never used the men's job.
Look, I respect you the same as everyone, but I always felt this show needed a woman's point of view. And of everyone here, you were the closest.
Well, I appreciate that, Max. I don't want to be here because I'm a woman. I want to be here because I'm a damn good writer. And if I have to be one of the fucking guys, I'll be one of the fucking guys. I can fucking handle it.
I agree. And I hope you have a great fucking baby there, fella.
Sorry, excuse me. I'm feeling better now.
What did you do, shave? You look different again.
Oh, I just washed up.
Where have I seen that suit before?
I wear it to work a lot. You once told me you liked it.
I did?
Sure.
All right. I'm the boss, so I'll pick the name.
Are you making bread or picking a name, Max?
Okay, I got one. Carol, you read it.
Oh, my God.
What?
Max Prince. It says Max Prince.
Okay, settled. I'm fired. So, now you can all relax.
Your name shouldn't be in there, Max.
Why not? Don't I write on the show? So I'm fired. Now I'm just a star.
But you're not listed on the credits as a writer, Max. So how do you save a salary?
I hired myself as a writer this morning. Now I fired myself. So I saved a big salary because I hired myself for a lot of money.
Let Aaron handle the bookkeeping problems. Okay, let's write next week's show.
Wait a minute. They all say Max Prince.
What are you? The Senate Investigating Committee? I don't want to lose a good writer. To me, you're all good. You think I'm stupid? Can we please get to work? Before his clothes change seasons again?
Do you have any evidence of any kind to indicate that there's any subversive amongst these young men? If not,
No.
No?
No what, Mr. Prince?
Him. Out. Don't want to see him. Off.
But, Mr. Prince, there's some people at the bar who do want to see him.
Yeah? Here's their bar bill. For the night. He's off the air.
Yes, Mr. Prince. And most
dangerously handed on. Oil and oil and stew and lard?
Sure.
Thank you, Mix.
I don't know who I hate more, McCarthy or Lawrence Welk.
Put Senator McCarthy back on.
Yes, Mr. Winchell.
The spot said you were...
This is what America wants to listen to, Max.
Is that right?
Watch that guy up there. He knows how to keep the audience's attention. Remember when you used to do that, Max?
Lean in. Next week's show, I want to be the Statue of Liberty. I want to wear a long gown down to my toes with a torch in my hand.
That's funny, Mix.
With big sandals and a tiara and a gigantic book in my other hand. And I'm painted all green with pigeon shit all over me. And I'm standing in a tub of water. And it says, give me your poor, your hungry, your sunburned, your toothless, your smelly, whatever they got there.
I love it. Then what?
She gets subpoenaed to Washington for being un-American.
Statue of Liberty? Why?
They don't care why. Anyway, she comes in the courtroom, and she's got seaweed all over her feet and codfish flipping in her hair.
This is funny. This is also dangerous.
Who cares? And he's sitting up there, Senator Joseph McNutcake.
McNutcake? We can't say that, Max. Not in the air.
Why not? We're not saying it's McCarthy.
America can put two and two together, Max.
Maybe not four and four, but they can manage two and two.
Come on, it's comedy. You don't think it's funny?
Very funny. But is 8 years in prison worth a few laughs?
We'll have to come from someone other than me.
May I say that, Mr.
Alfred!
Max, come on!
It was a good idea.
It's too dangerous, Max.
So we do nothing? Is that what you all want to do? Nothing?
I'd rather do nothing outside than do jail inside.
Get in the car, Harry. When the Roman legions, led by Augustus IV, fled in defeat, he came back to win on November the 5th.
November the 5th?
That's right. That was the Roman calendar. Aprus, Junus, and Novembus. And then came Christmas. You can look it up.
Look, all I'm saying is sometimes you have to make a stand against the bastards.
Well,
Well, this time it's a done deal. 2 months from now, I'll be living in Hollywood.
I'd give anything to live in Hollywood.
Well, that's all it takes, honey.
Max gave me this watch. Considering our problems, I thought that was very kind of him.
You know how you can repay him? At next week's rehearsal, come in wearing an all-white suit. Max will get a kick out of that.
Really? Max wants to see all the writers in his office.
He wants to say goodbye. I know it. I saw this movie.
Are we all here? Val? Ira? Carol?
Yes, Max, we're all here.
Did you have your baby yet?
3 months ago. It's a girl.
Oh, yeah? What's her name?
We don't know. She isn't talking yet.
Good. Good, Joe. You're as good as these guys, honey. Any day. I'm a little drunk, but I just wanted to say to everybody in this room, I just wanted to say I love you. Boy, why is that so hard to say? We never said it in my family. We said, eat. 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 Eat was love. Potatoes was love. Brisket or beef was a lot of love. But Harry can tell you, we didn't say it much. Right, Harry?
Right, Max. But I love you anyway.
God bless you, Harry. Anyway, I have some great news for all of you. We won. We beat the bastards, and we beat them together.
We won what, Max? Who did we beat?
NBC. They surrendered. At 5:25 tonight. Mm-hmm. They signed the surrender papers right here on my desk. Oh, it was like the end of the Civil War. Uh-huh. Grant and Robert E. Lee at Appomattox.
What did they surrender, Max?
What did we get? A new contract?
Better.
What's better than a contract, Max?
Freedom, independence. We're out! We're on our own from now on. We call all the shots.
You mean we can go to another network? CBS?
Damn right, CBS. Except they don't have any airtime next year.
I hear ABC's looking for new shows, Max.
Oh, there you are, ABC. But they just want to do sports. What am I going to do, play golf for an hour?
Well, there are only three networks, Max. Of course, there's always Channel 5, but they only got one camera.
Right. So, we played a waiting game. We wait until all the networks are in trouble, and then they line up for us with their tongues hanging out.
How long a wait are you talking about, Max?
Not long. We break up for a while. You guys take other shows. I'll do a movie in Vegas. And then the call comes. They want us back on our terms. Huh? Maybe a year, 2 years. So what if it's 10 years? We're all young. We'll only get better. It'll happen if we really want it. What do you think?
I'm in. You love me, Max. I love you.
There you go.
I have a slight problem with 10 years because my kids like to eat. But we'll see.
That's all I ask. Think about it. There's no rush. I just didn't want to say goodbye tonight. No goodbyes. All right.
I just said hello. Well, I don't want to say goodbye.
They didn't believe that Hannibal could cross 1,000 miles over the Alps on elephants. They said the elephants would all freeze and die. And you know what Hannibal said? He said, not if they're on all the way. God, I loved Hannibal. Okay. Everybody inside, let's celebrate. Helen! Helen!
Max.
Hi. Helen! Get my saxophone. I'm gonna play Sleigh Bells Roasting on an Open Fire. And just try and stop me.
He doesn't really mean 10 years, does he?
No, it's just a metaphor.
For what?
30 years.
Max knows it's over, and he knows we know it's over.
He didn't know how to say it. He had to hide behind somebody to say it the way he hides behind the character on a show.
Who was he just now?
Himself. First time in 35 years. Well, Max was a quiet kid. Would you believe it? I was the funny one. I was the comic. But I couldn't take the pressure. Not like Max. And I had nothing to teach him. He had a gift. And all of us learned from his gift. Sorry.
Harry talks? I knew he could nod. I didn't know he could talk.
Harry's right. Max was a giant. He was Moses. He was Goliath. All right, maybe he was Goliath after David hit him in the head with a rock. But there's greatness in him. I'm telling you guys, we just lived through history. Well, let's go in and join Moses before he eats up all the commandments.
You're not gonna believe this, but I'm gonna miss speaking fuck.
You're gonna miss speaking it. I'm gonna miss doing it. Come on, Lucas. I'm gonna teach you everything I know about comedy. Maybe you'll give me a job.
Well, like I said, think Hollywood. You'll love it, pal.
Listen, if you're Jewish, you end up in the desert no matter what.
I would have followed Max to the ends of the earth. But the earth went off the air on June 1st. Soon after, the press announced that the U.S. Senate voted to censure Joseph McCarthy for conduct unbecoming a senator. Television lost something when Max went off the air. We all did. Even the urbanated people.